Hi friends, in this video let us learn about the basic HTML completely. So first thing, anywhere you go, is you define your type of HTML that goes with HTML document type. So HTML page is why? Because when you want to go and create a web page or a website, you need something, some basic to create it. So that case you go for an HTML, which is a very basic thing. So here my doc type, what my doc type specifies is I give an exclamatory doc type and HTML. So what my doc type specifies is that my document type declaration, it stands for, so that the current version I am using is HTML5. So it is providing some information for the browser to understand like which version of HTML you are using. So next comes my HTML tag. Okay, I'll give my HTML tag. Okay, my HTML tag would basically get divided into two: head and body. Okay, so head is basically why? Because when you want to specify something that is common to the whole page, I give a title, I give a meta tag, I give a style, I give a script. Okay, so that is all about my head specifies. So let us see how to describe a comment now. Angle bracket, exclamatory, hyphen, hyphen. So my head provides info about style, script, title, meta. Okay. So hyphen, hyphen, angle bracket. This is how I define a comment in my HTML. So inside this I can give a title. So what I can give is my complete HTML. Okay, this is my complete HTML. So then what is my meta? The meta tag is used to define me about the information about my document. So say I am giving a name. So my name, I'm going to specify the author's name or my description. So document name. Okay, I'm creating an HTML document. So okay. So in the content part, I would describe it, that what it is about, a complete HTML package. Okay, a complete HTML package. This is all about, I'm going to tell over here. So my meta is useful to describe me about the information about my document. Apart from this, I can give style. Okay. Okay. So I have specified about style and formatting tags separately as well. I'll add you all the links in this video for your detailed explanation. Okay. Inside my body, I can have a heading. H1 defines my heading. So it ranges from H1 to H6, where H1 is my highest and H6 will be my lowest font. Okay, so here H1, I'm giving my heading. Okay. Okay, then we'll have a paragraph also created. Okay, here I will discuss about my paragraph. Okay, fine. Okay, now let us run this and see. I have my heading and also I have my paragraph getting displayed as well as my title, my complete HTML. Okay, so now I wanted to give a color to my HTML page. That is, it defines my style. And formatting is when you want to format your text, like I want to be italics. Or a stylist for the entire page, and your formatting will be specific to a text. So say I'll give a color to my page. So I'll give the attribute style equal to double quotes. So I'll give background hyphen color colon. Say I wanted to give light green. Okay. Then it would end with a semicolon and double quotes. Okay. See, my page is now in light green color. Fine, right? So like this I can give a background image. If you want, you can give a background image, you can give a link of that, or you can also give colors to your specific thing. So here also inside your h1, when you wanted to give a specific color, I can go and give color colon. So I'll give style equal to color colon, I'll give yellow, okay, and double quotes. So see, this is in yellow color. So I can give inline. So when I go for my styles, it will be of three types. I can have inline. So all this will be covered in CSS. For easy understanding, I'm just giving a basic. So inline, embedded, and external. So inline is when I'm giving inside my tag itself, like specific we are giving, right? So that is inline. And if I wanted to give something specific for my whole page or my multiple tags are using, then I go with the style. See here, even here I can go and give my body color. So body, so I can give, okay, so I can give this parameter over here. Instead of giving here, I can give my background color colon this has here, and I can remove it from here. Okay. See, then also you are getting the same thing. So this is called embedded. That is, you are giving inside your style only, but that is inside your page. What is external is when I am importing it from an other CSS file. So I am creating a separate CSS file and I am importing it. So that would come under my external style format. So next comes, what if I have to format it? So we have many formatting: italics, bold, strike through, emphasis, many things of this, where I'll discuss you here very basic things. So see, I have here something like I want this to be bold. Okay, so then I will give B tag is used to define my bold. Okay, see, it is coming in bold. What if I want them to be displayed in italics? So then I go with creating I for italics. Okay, so now what if I want them to be underlined? You can also underline a specific thing as well. So if you wanted to underline discuss, you have to give your U tag inside this. And also you can give multiple things. I can also give underline, also I can give italics as well here. See, but the order you close should be same. So italics, underline should close first, then my italic should get closed next. Okay, so see, I am having in italics. So this would be my basic formatting styles. Okay, so I am done with my formatting now. So what if I wanted to create a link? So my A tag is helpful for me in creating a link. Fine. How do I create it? I go for href is my attribute inside which I specify my link. So I'll give a URL, valid URL. So http://www.google.com. Okay. So this will not anyway be getting displayed in my browser. That is the URL I wanted to go. So inside this, I'll give my Google page link. So this would get displayed in your browser, and on click of that, you will be navigating to that page. Okay. Okay, here Google page link. So on click of that, it is taking me to Google page, right? Okay, I'm giving a break here. Break. So this break is why? Because when I want a line to be inserted after a statement, then I go for a break. I can do multiple breaks. Okay, then what if I wanted to insert an image? I go for an image tag. Okay, so I want to specify some image location, right? So I'll copy this location. Here inside my image tag, I have an attribute called src. So src is defined my source of my file. So it should be a forward slash. So here avocado.png. Okay. See, I'm getting an avocado picture here. Okay. Okay. Now, what if my image is not there or I am giving a wrong one? So, in that case, what happens is my browser will just display an image box over here which does not have anything. So, I need to provide some alternative, right? What if it goes wrong? So in that case, what I will do is I'll give an attribute called alt, whereas I specify in text what I was supposed to give over there. So that is avocado. Okay, right. So now what happens is it displays me an avocado. I was supposed to give an image, but that is not currently available. But this text will get displayed only if your image is not found. If your image is correct, then it will not get displayed. But if I want to size it, so width is equal to, can give 20%, okay, 20%. And if I want to specify some height, okay, so 20%, okay. See, I can resize my image. This is how do you resize your images. Okay, so far we have covered very basic of HTML, how to create it. So normal, how to create a body, what goes inside your body, what goes inside your head, how to create an hyperlink, and how to create an image. Fine. So the next part that would come here is creating a list. I wanted to create a list. So now let us take all these things. Okay, let it be here. I will create a list. Okay, I'm giving a break here. Okay, so there are four types of list I can have it. So I can have a ordered list. Okay, like 1, 2, 3 or ABC. Also, I can have an unordered list that comes with my bullet sign. Okay, and also I can have nested list. Inside a list, I can have another list, and description list. Description list is where you would go and provide some descriptions. Okay. Okay. So about here, I will cover, as it is basics, I'll cover you ordered and unordered list. So in a separate video, we have already covered about this nested list and description list. Okay. So first, let us go with creating an unordered list. So my unordered list goes with UL. Okay. So then my LI is my list. So I can give here something like I wanted to give a list, right? So max signs. Okay. So and my list should get closed. Okay. So now let us run our page. See, by default, what my unordered list will give me is a bullet sign. That is a circle. Actually, it is a circle. So, apart from this, I also have square, disc shape. And if I am giving none, nothing would get displayed. So, where I can specify it? Inside my UL tag, I will go with style equal to double quotes again. So, list hyphen style hyphen type. So, it's giving me, right? So list hyphen style hyphen colon is equal to, I'm giving a square now. See, it is getting changed to square. So also you can give the size and other attributes as how you have. Okay. Now how do I? Okay. Next is I wanted to create an ordered list. So then I go with my tag OL. Okay. So here, copy, paste. So I will get an ordered list to be created now. That by default my ordered list will start with 1 and 2. true. So what if I want them to be in alphabets? Then I specify here type is equal to A. Okay, so now my ordered list will start with A, B and C and it continues. Okay, so this is mainly about a introduction to list. Okay, now I have created a list. Next thing I wanted to go is I wanted to go for a table. I wanted to present something in my table. So how do I create a table? So for creating a table, so let us I'll create a separate page for that. Okay. So we'll create, so form and table, let us give form table dot, okay, dot HTML. Okay. Okay, my table tag is used to define me a table, right? So table, okay, this defines I'm going to create a table. So when I want a table, I will have rows and columns and I have a heading for my row. So first thing I would do is I would create the border for my table. Okay. So see, I want my table to be in a border, right, in a box. So I can give a style tag in common for my table data and my heading. Okay, so I'll give a style where I wanted to define my table th and my data, that is my heading and my data. Okay, how do I specify? I wanted to give a border. So border colon, I'll give 1 pixel which is solid black. Okay, there are so many attributes we can learn. So background color, what if I wanted to give some background hyphen color colon, I am giving light green. Okay. Now how do I create a heading for my, so first I would go with my row. So when we have a table format, how does it look for us is, say I have a name, then I'll have a class, then here I'll have one, then say here I will have a value for that, similarly I'll have two and I'll have a value for that. So this comes in my heading part, but this is my first row, right? So I'll create first a row tr. Okay, I'll also give an ending tag tr. Okay, this denotes my row. Then I wanted to go with an heading for my row that denotes th, and I'll also end my th. Okay, inside which I will give name. Okay, I'll create one more heading, is called college name. Okay, fine. Now let us see whether our table has got created. See, I have my table with my background color of my table and this got displayed. Fine. Now how do I give data into it? So that data would go in my second row, right? So I'm creating one more row for my table. So here it goes as TD. So TD, I'll give some name as ABC and I'm ending it. I'm also creating one more data because I have my college name, right? So TD, I'm giving SSM and I'm ending it. Okay. If I wanted to give one more data, I'll again create one more row with the data I wanted to give. So here I'll give X, Y, Z. My college name would be same. Okay. So see, I have created a table now. So this is a very basic thing of creating a table. You can also give your color to a table. You can specify the width of your table here inside table. When you give your style attribute, you can give width of your table, you can give a caption, you can align your text, you can combine two tables. So all these things for beginners, I have created this video. So all these things in detail I have defined in a separate video where you will have HTML tables complete for full demonstration. So now we have created a basic table. Fine. So the next thing that we would have is the other basic part of an HTML would be the forms. Okay, the forms form the major part in an HTML, because till now, so far, whatever we have seen is only the very basic thing, and also it specifies your static content of your page. So none of them are like interacting with one another. So once it comes for your form only, then you will have something meaningful. You will have something interactive. On click of something, I wanted to go to this page, or on click of this, I wanted to display this text. So like that. So when you want your web pages to be more interactive, then you would go with your form. Okay. Now let us see about how to create a form. So my form is my tag that is used to create a form. Okay, start and end tag we have given now. Fine. So first thing we will learn is to create a simple text box. Okay, so say we will take this as an example itself. So I'm having a name. Okay, I wanted to input something, right? So it goes with my input tag. Inside my input tag only I will define all other details. So input, start you can give, and also an end tag. Okay, fine. So inside my input, what goes is the first thing should be my type. So be it a text, a radio button, or a checkbox, whatever. So first I'm going to create a simple text. So type is equal to text. Okay. So the name is an attribute that is mandatory in a form, because when you want to make this form to be interactive and make the use of this values in a page, be it in your server side or in the same front end, you need this name. Okay. So for now, let us just give as name. Then value. So this value, when I wanted to give a value explicitly, I'll go and give value. Otherwise I would not give any value over here. Okay, so here I'm giving a break where I wanted to create another line. So only input you will give. Okay, it does not have any empty tag, right? Next, so I'm giving college. Okay, I'll copy the same thing. So here let us give college, value SSM let us give. Fine. Okay, now let us run this and see. See, I have got a name and my college. So this is something that is editable. So if I do not give any value over here, I'll just have a text box getting displayed over there. Fine. Okay. So what if I want some field to be hidden? When we consider our password, it should be hidden, right? So I have to create a password field. Okay. So in that case, what my type would be is I would give a type as password. So let us see how does it works. So I'll create one more field, password, where whatever I'm typing here will be masked. I can't see. That is how we create, how we have all the password fields in whatever form we are submitting. So that is how my form will be. Okay, so now I wanted to give something more descriptive. Okay, say I wanted to give my description of my college. Okay, so I'll give description. Okay, So my text area is used to do specify me that part. Okay, so it will have a start tag and an end tag. Right, okay. So what is this is, so say my college name is SSM. I'm doing my PG. Okay. So you will have a text area to be displayed by default. So I wanted to specify the height and width of my text area. Then what I will go and do is, inside my text area, I will give the attribute rows equal to, say, 5 I can give. Then I can give calls that specify my column. I can give some 50. When I wanted to give something more descriptive, I'll go with this. Okay, see, so you can type any much till that 50 rows you can type. So it will come like an expandable box. Okay, fine. Now we are done with creating a text area. Okay, the next part that would be is, what if I want them to be described in a confined space? Okay, I want the entire form to be in a confined space. Then I go with a tag called field set, where it itself creates me a box inside my form. Okay. So, field set. See, I'm getting a box wherein which my form is getting displayed. Okay. Fine. Okay. What if I wanted to give a name to this? So then I go with the tag legend. Okay, here my college information. Right? Okay. Now let us see how does it looks. So see, my college information. Fine. Right. So far, like, we have created a normal text box, a text area, and other those things. Okay. So now I will have, I wanted to specify here after this. Okay. Now in this, let us see, next part is how to create a radio button. So my radio button would go with input, type equal to radio. So when do we actually go for creating a radio button is, when I want to select one among the multiple options that is present, right? So here I'm giving degree here. Okay, so this let it be BTech. Next one, I'm creating one more input type equal to radio and name equal to degree, closing it, I'm giving BE. So now let us see that. So see, I am having BTech, or I can select BE, either of the one. So next is, when I want to select only when I want one thing to be selected by default, then what I would go and do is, I would give checked. So here when I'm giving checked, my BTech degree would be automatically selected by default. So now let us refresh this page. See here. So I can then go and select my BE. Okay. Now I'm going to give my subjects in my degree. So in that case, what I would do is, I would not go for a radio button. Rather, I would be interested in going for something that gives me, enable me to check multiple items. So here, next I'll give a paragraph where I'll specify my subjects. Okay. Okay, so here I am giving an input where my type would be equal to what? Checkbox. So checkbox name is equal to subject. Next, I am giving here English, a break, okay, I'm giving max, I'm giving science. Okay, so now let us see that. So I'm giving my subject, so I can select multiple things. So here also by default, when I want something to be checked, I can give the tag checked. Okay, here also I can select multiple things where, so I can give checked. Okay. So now on running this, we could see my English and Max would get checked by default. If I wanted to select science, I can select my science as well. So this is how our checkbox will work, where you wanted to select multiple items. Okay. Next comes the drop down. What if I wanted to select something from a drop down? So when it goes for a drop down, you would go with the tag. Two tags are important. One is select, another one is option. Okay, so select. So select name is equal to drop down. Okay, this specifies that I'm going to create a drop down and I am closing my select tag. Okay, so inside my options I have to give option, so value equal to, say I'm giving what are all the places where currently I'm going to go. So I'll give, be it my lab. Okay, first thing I would give is my lab. So here I will give lab and my option tag would end over here. Okay. So and also I am selecting so I will give library. Next I would give my class. Okay. So library and I would give class. Okay, so now let us run this and see how this is working. So here see, in my drop down I have my library, class, and anything can be selected. What if I here, like here in radio button and my checkbox, I have like checked, right? So what if similarly I wanted to select something here, then I will go with the word, the attribute called selected. Okay, so let us keep selected for library, because by drop down first my lab would get selected, right? So I'm giving selected. So see, my library would get selected by default. If I want to select something else, then I can go and select that. So this is how, this is all the basic things that we need to know about the forms. Okay, the next comes is our ID and classes. Okay, ID and classes in our HTML. What is ID and classes is used for us? When I want some to specify some property for, that is unique across my tag. So for H1, my tag should be only this color. Then I would go for an ID. When I wanted to specify something, I'm using across multiple things. Be it I wanted to give the same for my H1. I wanted to give the same for my H2. Then I go for a class. My ID attribute would be specified by hash that particular ID name. Okay, then my class would be specified by means of dot operator. So let us see that. Okay, so here we have table, right? Before, okay, So say I wanted to create a paragraph. I'm creating two paragraph, okay. Okay, here I am giving, I have described about table. Here I am giving, I have described about forms. Right, so I am giving multiple things for which I am going to specify you about my class first. Okay, here I am giving class equal to some name info. Okay, and also here I would give control C class info. So now what happens is inside my style it would go and check for a dot attribute with the name info. There I can define, say I wanted to define a color, so color colon red. Okay, so now let us run this and see how it looks. See, okay, I have given an extra angle bracket here. So info is something where I wanted to specify that this common to my entire class. Okay, sometimes see I have a heading. Okay, I want my heading alone to be specified unique. Okay, so here what I would do is I would give a heading. I'm giving my heading. Okay, my complete HTML, right? Okay, so here my ID would be specified by hash, and here I should give the name my heading, again open bracket and a close bracket. I would give color colon LO, right? So that is what ID is, something that is unique, and your class attribute is something that would be shared across some of the elements. Like when you wanted a property that this should be shared across multiple elements of a class, then you would go with the attribute called class. So apart from this ID and class, so this will cover our basic complete HTML, and we have some more tags that we can discuss now. So I will give specifying that, say I wanted something to get displayed in a quotation, then I would go for that tag called Q. Okay, so Q, when I'm giving Q, so it displays me in a double quotes. See, my HTML is getting displayed in my double quotes. And one more thing what we have faced is, see, we are using angle bracket, right? So when we want this greater than and less than symbol to be displayed, how we would go is, so I can give here ampersand L T semicolon. So that defines my lesser than symbol, and ampersand GT, G for greater than, so that would define my greater than symbol. So see, I'm getting a less than as well as the greater than symbol. So suppose I wanted to print something above my letter and below my letter, then I would go with the name of superscript and subscript. How do I define a superscript and subscript? Okay. P, giving A sub 2, I'm ending my subscript here and I'm ending my paragraph here. Okay, so now my 2 should get displayed below because it is a subscript. So when I wanted to give superscript, I will give SUP, and also here I would give SUP. So now this would display in my upper part. So this basically covers our complete HTML, where we discussed about the basic tags, styles, attributes, forms, tables, formatting, everything. This is for the beginners. If you want to know about each and every topic in detail, you can watch our channel other videos where we have explained about most of the tags and elements that would be covered as part of HTML. So if you like this video, please do like, share and subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.